Hey, what's going on everybody? It's ETA Prime back here again with another Launchbox tutorial. Today we're going to be covering Final Burn Neo. And with this, we're actually going to be using the Core and Retro Arch, and this is kind of an alternative to MAME. It's just as accurate as the current version of MAME, but in my opinion, it is a lot easier to use, and one of my main use case scenarios for this are my favorite fighting arcade games. But remember, Final Burn Neo does support a lot of systems. If we take a look at the RetroArch wiki, you can see that it supports ColecoVision, Channel F, MSX1, PC Engine, Super Graphics, Turbo Graphics, Master System, Mega Drive, and so on and so on. And to tell you the truth, a lot of the time, these Final Burn Neo packs will kind of consist of those type of games. And another thing to keep in mind is, a lot of these systems do require a BIOS. So you can actually head over to the LibRetro wiki, I'll leave a link for this in the description, tells you exactly what BIOS you need per system. You can see here for Neo Geo, we'll need that Neo Geo.zip, Neo Geo CD, so on and so on. But overall, I do think it's a great emulator, and it's definitely worth setting up in your Launchbox collection. So if you want to get this up and running, let's go ahead and get started. So first things first, you're obviously going to need some games or ROMs. Now there are a lot of pre-curated packs out there, but if you want to, you can go ahead and make your own. I've got one right here that consists of a lot of great games, and this actually also has some Neo Geo games. And my ROM set was created from a merged set, so I do need the Neo Geo BIOS. But keep in mind, if you create your own Final Burn Neo ROM set, try to use the non-merged set, that way you don't need to add this BIOS in. And all of these ROMs are going to stay zip. They won't work if they're unzipped with Final Burn Neo. So I've already taken my ROM set, and I've placed it in my Launchbox directory under Games for easy access. That way I can keep this all portable, located right here. Got everything that I want to import here for Final Burn Neo. And once you have your games you want to import into Launchbox, we need to set up the emulator. So this is really easy now that we have the automatic RetroArch downloader inside of Launchbox. If you don't already have it set up, we can head up to Tools, Manage, RetroArch, and from here you can install it, you can reinstall or update. I'm going to go ahead and update my RetroArch. It's going to do this automatically for us. And the great thing about this RetroArch downloader and updater in Launchbox is it downloads all of the updated cores for us also at the same time. So this is going to pre-configure RetroArch for us. And there we have it. RetroArch was updated successfully. If you just installed it, it'll give you a notification letting you know it's installed. Now it's time to import our games, because the RetroArch emulator is already set up. We don't have to go to Manage Emulators or anything like that. From the Tools dropdown, Import, ROM Files, we're going to find our Final Burn Neo folder. I'm going to import the full folder. Remember, all of those games need to stay zip. So from Launchbox, Games, Final Burn Neo, we'll choose Next. And from here, we're going to create a new platform, and we're going to call it Final Burn Neo. We want to scrape this system as an arcade system. We'll choose Next. Our emulator is going to be RetroArch. And we also need to choose our core. Since we let Launchbox automatically download and set up RetroArch, we've got all the cores we need. From the dropdown, we're going to find the Final Burn Neo core, which is named FBNeo_LibRetro. Right here, we'll go ahead and make sure this is selected. We'll choose Next. I'm going to use the files in their current location because I've already placed them in my Launchbox directory. We want to search for game information from the local metadata database. Scrape as much as we can for these, so I'm going to leave everything checked here. And if you are using EMU movies, you can do the same. We don't need to specify any custom options for Final Burn Neo. And once Launchbox parses everything, you'll see we've got our games, ROM location, and extension. They should all be .zip or 7z. Finish, and let Launchbox do its thing. It's going to import all of these games, download our metadata and artwork. And once Launchbox is finished up, we now have a new section over here in the left-hand column known as Final Burn Neo. I usually like going through here just to see if it's scraped everything properly. And it looks pretty good. Yeah, it looks like it caught everything. So we're almost ready to start playing our games, but there's one last thing we need to do. All of our games here are zipped, and the way Launchbox is set up with RetroArch right now for this core is it's going to try to extract that ROM. Unfortunately, if it tries to extract it, we're only going to get an error when we start it up. So we're going to go to Tools, Manage, Emulators. From here, we're going to find RetroArch, Edit, on the left-hand column, Associated Platforms, and we need to find the Final Burn Neo core that we're using. FBNeo_Libretro. We're going to uncheck the second option here, Extract ROMs. That way, it doesn't try to extract when we start the game up. We're going to choose OK. We'll close this down. And now all that's left to do is start playing our favorite games. I'm going to go with JoJo's Venture. Just going to double click on it. We've got those awesome loading screens here. And it'll take us right into the game. We can go ahead and exit. It'll bring us right back into Launchbox. And yeah, there we have it. We've now got Final Burn Neo set up. Lots of great games here to mess around with. And like I mentioned, it is kind of an alternative to MAME. It's really up to you if you want to use this or not. But in my experience, sometimes this has actually been a little easier to use. So you might want to start out with this, then you can move over to MAME. In the end, it's really up to you. But it's here. Figured we'd go ahead and get the tutorial out and hope you get this up and running in your Launchbox setup. If you've got any questions, let us know in the comments below. And like always, thanks for watching.